Now, Mr. Smith, why don't you lie down on this couch and I'll take a few notes.
Okay.
Now, what seems to be the problem?
I think I'm paranoid.
Paranoid, Mr. Smith?
Yes, I feel that deep down I know right from wrong. I know how I'm supposed to behave and that I don't do what I know I'm supposed to do. And I keep making excuses for why I'm not doing the right thing. And I'm afraid that someday I'm going to stand before God and have to account for what I've done and I won't have any excuses. What was that?
Nothing, Mr. Smith. I just broke my pencil.
So, do you think I'm paranoid?
Not at all. Paranoia is when your fears are based on facts that are not true.
So I'm not paranoid?
No, you're not.
Oh, so everything I'm afraid of is true!
Well, that's right.
Huh?
There is a standard we know we are supposed to live by, and none of us are living up to it. But that's why God offers to forgive us, if we will only agree we need to be forgiven.
I could have read that in the Bible.
Would have been cheaper, too. That'll be $80.
A message from Lifeline Productions. 1-800-52-FUNNY. At lifelinepro.com.
Good morning, this is Radio Good News. The goal of this program is to draw all people to the love of Jesus Christ. I want everyone to know and experience the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Those are key to a Holy Spirit-filled and successful Christian life. I will focus on God's love because God's love is wonderful. I'm John Thornton. You can write to me at Radio Good News, P.O. Box 1722, Sioux Falls, South Dakota, 57101. We've been doing some interviews lately, and I'd like to know what you think. We have a special guest on today, so if you want to comment about that, write to me at Box 1722, Sioux Falls, South Dakota, 57101. I'm John Thornton, and I'll be reading from the Bible, the New Revised Standard Version, because that is God's word to us in our modern English language. Let's begin today with Psalm 96, verses 1 through 6. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all the peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He is to be revered above all gods. For all the gods of the peoples are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Those are God's words from Psalm 96, verses 1 through 6. And if you have young children at home, you might recognize the next tune because our music today is from Veggie Tales.
You were lying in your bed. You were feeling kind of sleepy. But you couldn't close your eyes because the room was getting creepy.
Were those eyeballs in the closet? Was that Godzilla in the hall?
There was something big and hairy casting shadows on the wall. Now your heart is beating like a drum. Your skin is getting clammy. There's 100 tiny monsters jumping right into your jammies.
What are you gonna do?
I'm going to call the police.
No, you don't need to do anything.
What? Why?
Because...
God is bigger than the boogeyman. He's bigger than Godzilla or the monsters on TV. Oh, God is bigger than the boogeyman. And he's watching out for you and me.
So when I'm lying in my bed, the furniture starts creeping, I'll just laugh and say, hey, cut that out, and get back to my sleeping, cause I know that God's the biggest, and he's watching all the while. So when I get scared, I'll think of him and close my eyes and smile.
God is bigger than the boogeyman. He's bigger than Godzilla or the monsters on TV. Oh, God is
that I scared you when you saw me on TV.
Well, that's okay, because now I know that God is taking care of me.
God is bigger than the boogeyman. He's bigger than Godzilla or the monsters on TV. Oh, God is bigger than the boogeyman, and he's watching out for you and me.
One more time!
God is bigger than the boogeyman. He's bigger than Godzilla or the monsters on TV.
That was a tune from a Veggie Tales video. At the end of the program today, we're going to have a song from the Jonah movie, a Veggie Tales movie that's coming out October 4th. So stay tuned for that. Turn with me, if you can, to Matthew's Gospel, to chapter 5, verses 13 through 16. Matthew 5, 13 through 16. Here Jesus says, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven." Those are Jesus' words from Matthew chapter 5, verses 13 through 16. Usually at this stage in the program we have a scripture lesson, but this morning we have a very special guest. On the telephone with me this morning is the director of music for Big Idea Productions, the Veggie Tales people, Kurt Heinecke. Welcome to Radio Good News.
Good to be here. Good to meet you, Steve.
So tell us a little bit about your own history, your own spiritual journey, and how you've gotten to be part of the Veggie Tales people.
Well, it's interesting. I've always waited for the door to open in the jobs that I've had in the past. I started out as a band director. I taught in the Bahamas for 6 months. I moved to Chicago after that. I taught band in an elementary school, and I got hooked up with a contemporary church in downtown Chicago, Park Community Church. And on occasion, I would help them with their music as they were looking for some help with the music. And as I became more involved in that, it became a part-time position one summer, and then we enjoyed it so much it became a full-time position after that, and I stepped down from my band directing job. The door there was clearly opened by the Lord. It wasn't something that I was specifically seeking. Well, after a couple years of being at this church, I hooked up with Phil and Lisa Vischer. Lisa, who is the voice of Junior Asparagus, was quite active in the music department. She would sing a lot. I would work with her every other week or so. Mike Naraki, who's Larry the Cucumber, Phil Vischer, who's Bob the Tomato, also were at the church. And as Phil started getting this desire and vision for creating the VeggieTales series, he was going to need some help with the music. Both he and Mike do an incredible job of writing a lot of the music, but they needed help at the beginning there with things like arranging and performing and producing and getting everything put together. They had the songs in their heads, but they didn't know how to get them onto the finished product. So, and we didn't have a big budget back then either. They had a very, very little budget, so they weren't able to, say, go to Nashville or go to Los Angeles and find a top name music producer. So they invited me to help out. I was at the church with them. They had seen me work in the church for a number of years. And so that's how it all started. We, when you watch the very first show, Where's God When I'm Scared, the virtually everybody involved in that show except for one person came out of the same church. The voice talent came from our drama team. There are a couple musicians that played on it that I had worked with. So it's a neat little story how it got started and how we all met at this church together. And once again, the door opened for that. I have always sought God in in my future plans as opposed to making my own 5-year or 10-year plan, because I, frankly, I don't know what the Lord has in store, and right now he's blessed me with the opportunity to work with VeggieTales. So there's a long answer for you.
Well, tell us a little bit, if somebody's brand new and has never heard of VeggieTales, I can't imagine where they were, but if they've never heard of VeggieTales, what is VeggieTales?
What is VeggieTales? Well, we are, first of all, Big Idea Productions is the company that creates VeggieTales. We are a family entertainment company built on a biblical worldview. We believe that there is a God, and we benefit from a relationship with him, and everything that we present in our shows starts from that foundation. So VeggieTales was our first and our most popular way of expressing that through computer animated video. We have a series of characters that are all vegetables: Bob the tomato, Larry the cucumber, and a whole boatload of others.
Well, you do have the peach, and he's not quite a vegetable, so.
I'm sorry, what?
You do have the peach, so he's not a vegetable.
Well, you know what, and we don't like to say this a lot, but, you know, tomatoes are actually fruits. So, you know, Bob the tomato is actually a fruit, but we didn't think fruit tales had a nice ring to it. So, but we're an equal opportunity employer, so we'll let fruit in when they'd like to come in.
Now, I believe one of your mottos is something about Saturday morning fun with Sunday morning values?
Exactly. We're trying to capture what's the best way to tell people what we are. And we like to say that, hey, kids think of Saturday mornings, think of cartoons, a lot of fun. Parents think of Sunday mornings, Sunday school, getting some teaching for their kids. We serve up both of them. It's like going to a playground, meeting a bunch of kids, and you've got a Twinkie in one hand and an apple in the other. What are the kids going to want to eat? The Twinkie. What's going to be better for them? The apple. So what we've tried to do is create an apple that tastes like a Twinkie.
Now, you're not telling us a new character is coming out that is a Twinkie, are you?
No, we wouldn't go that far. But in Jonah, the movie that's coming out, we've got a Khalil who is a caterpillar, so he's not a vegetable, and he's got limbs, so we're stretching out here.
Now, tell us a little bit about how the music plays a part in Big Idea Productions. The videos that I've seen, the music is just outstanding. It's very sophisticated, and yet it's incredibly fun. Tell us about your music.
Well, yeah, it is a lot of fun. We've always put music at the forefront. It's a very important part of the stories. Mike and Phil have always stressed music as an important part of the shows. With my music background, it's just been a lot of fun to be able to work on these shows. And we never play down to the kids. I've got a music degree. I've always enjoyed taking the simple melodies that we write that are real catchy and kind of stick in your head, but then putting a lot of depth behind that in the arrangement and the performance and the instruments that we use. So there's always, I love to get as much richness in there as I can. Same with our scores. As our shows have gotten bigger, and now as we're coming out with Jonah, you know, we've gotten to use a full orchestra to score a complete movie, and there's a lot of depth and richness there.
So would you say that Jonah is a musical?
It's a movie with some sung songs in it. You could call it a musical. I think when I think of a musical, I think of The Sound of Music, where there's maybe a dozen tunes. We've got three or four really good numbers in there. So, you know what? You could call it a musical. And they're great songs, just like people have come to expect from VeggieTales. And then we've got a full hour of score underneath there also.
And it's not just your own performers anymore. Don't you have people like the Newsboys and some other people like that
coming
in?
Yeah, we've been very excited this time around. We've got Anointed singing just it's a showstopper of a number. Can't give away exactly what happens, but it's a show-stopping gospel number that people will want to be standing up and clapping in the movie theater. The Newsboys are involved. Chris Rice is involved on the CD project. David Mullen is involved with us in writing some of the songs. His wife is Nicole C. Mullen, a Dove Award winner, and David is also a top-notch writer and multiple Dove Award winner in Nashville. So it's been just a lot of fun to be able to work with some of these other people that I've always admired.
So tell us with Veggie Tales, how did you get to the point of making 30-minute videos, mostly for home audiences, to where you're having a nationwide production of a big theatrical release of Jonah? How did that evolution happen?
Well, as we were spending more time on our half-hour videos, they really were becoming mini-movies. We were spending so much money and so much time on them, we thought, boy, this, you know, the natural progression here is the movie theater. It's been wonderful, and we're going to it's been wonderful doing half-hour videos, and we're going to continue doing them. But I think Phil Vischer's and the rest of our dreams has always been the big screen where a lot of people can gather together and enjoy, you know, the experience together with the big sound system, big screen. And you've got a longer format. You know, we've got it's about an 80, 85-minute movie. We can develop a bigger story. You know, everything about it, the visuals are much more elaborate. There's much more depth to them, richness. You know, the music, we've got a 55-piece orchestra instead of myself on some of the first shows, you know, playing my synthesizer. We've got, you know, acts like Anointed and Newsboys involved. So everything has taken up several steps, and it's really exciting to see that. And yet, I know some people say, well, but do you lose the flavor of VeggieTales when it becomes a movie? And I'd have to say, absolutely not. We've got all the humor, all the great songs, all those fun little inside jokes for the teenagers and college students and adults. All of that is still there.
So, Kurt, tell us a little bit also about the other projects. There's VeggieTales and the Jonah movie, which I believe comes out October 4th.
Well, the Jonah movie, Jonah, a VeggieTales movie, comes out October 4th. You're absolutely right. It's going to appear in at least 1,100 theaters nationwide. You can go to our website, bigidea.com, or jonah.com. I think it's jonah.com or jonahmovie.com. I'm not sure which. You can help find out where in your area a theater will be showing it, or just check your local listings the week of October 4th. But yes, we will be nationwide October 4th.
So how have the preliminary reviews of the movie gone? How have people accepted it? And
it's been very exciting. We did a showing in Los Angeles a couple months ago, not for a Christian audience, but for just people that were invited to see a computer animated movie.
Kind of a sneak preview kind of thing?
Yeah, and it was, we wanted to test it and just see the response. There's questions that you ask these people afterwards, and the excitement was unbelievable. The scores came back twice as good as the typical family-oriented movie. Everybody was, for the most part, very, very happy with it. And then we also showed it for, we did have a preview for the Christian Booksellers Association, also in Anaheim in July. And just, there's no doubt in our minds that our core audience, our fans that have been with us all along, are just going to love it. All of them that we talked to just absolutely loved it. It's got a wonderful story. I mean, this wonderful story, Old Testament story of Jonah getting swallowed by a whale and spit back up. You know, that's the part that the kids remember, but there's such a richness to the God's message of giving us all second chances. He gave Jonah a second chance. Jonah didn't die in the whale. God gave him a second chance. That lesson still applies today. God is still the same God. He still gives us second chances. That's the underlying theme of the movie, and it's very exciting to see a movie coming out with a clear biblical message based on, you know, the foundations of Christianity.
Now, a few years ago, there was the movie Prince of Egypt that came out, and I believe you have some people that actually worked on that movie that are now with Big Idea.
You know, we have grown from 10 people several years ago to almost 200 now, and we've had people like Dan Phillips and Amik Owens who have actually come from DreamWorks. They've worked on movies like Prince of Egypt and Road to El Dorado. We've had some other people, several, that have come from the Disney studios that have worked on movies like Lion King that have brought their expertise also to the table. And it's really exciting to see other people, other believers that have similar beliefs as us, that just are excellent in their fields, have worked at the tops of their fields at places like DreamWorks and Disney, that are willing to sometimes take a price cut and come here and do what they've always wanted to do, and that's be able to use their talents to spread a more meaningful message than they've been able to do in the past.
So it seems that God is bringing a lot of different people to Big Idea that want to be part of making the world better and part of the solution rather than just doing the typical business kind of things.
Absolutely. It's exciting. I hope that we're breaking ground for other companies to follow in our footsteps in the sense of presenting something with a Christian worldview, a biblical worldview, and yet done with excellence. And people can say, yeah, that's what I've always wanted to do. You know, if they can do it, I think I can too. And I'm gonna start my own company, or I'm gonna do my own animation, or whatever that may be that's reaching not just the church down the street, but is reaching the neighbors of that church and the friends and the kids that go to their school. It's real exciting to be involved in something like that.
Well, Kurt, in the few minutes we have left, tell us a little bit more about music, since that's your major focus here. I've noticed with Veggie Tales that it's not just one kind of music, but it's a whole lot of genres of music, but it all has the Veggie Tales kind of take on it. Tell us about that.
Yeah, I remember we did an interview, Phil and I did an interview once, and that question came up, and Phil said, the only rule we have is no pop music. And what he meant by that is, it's hard to poke fun at yourself with pop music because a lot of today's popular music takes itself so seriously. And so that's our philosophy. We have a lot of fun with different genres. I love working in this area because, like Mike Naraki, when Mike and I write a silly song, here's an example of what will happen. Let's take Endangered Love, for example. That's the song about the manatees on the soap opera.
Oh, with Barbara Manatee.
Exactly. Barbara Manatee. Yeah, Mike came to me and said, okay, I've got this idea for a silly song. It involves, albino manatees on a soap opera. It's going to be a tango, and this is the chorus. Barbara Manatee, you are the one for me, sent from up above. You are the one I love. He had that. It's a good thing I don't sing too much on our videos. And he also had the lyrics of the rest of the song. But he said, I want it to sound like a tango, and I don't know what else I'm going to do with the song. So at that point, I step into the picture, and I build out the rest of the song, write the melodies for the rest of the song, and then we study what a tango is. And I'm going to skip that call, that's a call waiting here. We study what a tango is, so we rented a couple movies about tangos, we bought a couple CDs on tangos, and I actually research, a tango, because I hadn't written a tango before, so I found out, here's the rhythms that it uses, common instruments like violin and accordion and piano. So it was just a hoot for me to write an authentic tango. If you took the lyrics away from that song, you'd have just a legitimate tango. And in and of itself, it's not that funny. There's a quirkiness to it because it's a tango and we don't hear tangos every day. But then you put the story and the lyrics and Larry on top of that, and that's where the humor comes in. So it's fun to juxtapose the legitimate music, because actually then that makes what Larry's doing that much funnier. Because, of course, Larry always takes himself seriously. He thinks he's doing the right thing, and we're laughing at him as we watch him. And so that happens over and over when we take different musical styles. We've got a VeggieTales show coming up that's going to be a Western. It's going to be a Western, so I'm going to, go watch some Bonanza and...
High Plains Drifter or something.
I'm sorry, what?
Or something like High Plains Drifter.
Yeah, exactly.
Some of the music like that.
So it's, and we've done a lot of polkas in the past. It's fun to use traditional music because it also kind of stands the test of time.
So in the Jonah movie, we have just a couple minutes left here. What kind of styles of music are people going to hear throughout the Jonah movie? I know there's the Newsboy song in the belly of the whale, but there's Chris Rice's song. What other styles are they going to hear?
Well, first of all, in a movie with a score, they're going to hear a dramatic, emotional movie soundtrack, a score with a full 55-piece orchestra. There's a lot of drama in the movie. I'm not giving anything away if I tell you that Jonah gets swallowed by a whale and there's a ship that they're on. There's a storm. So there's some dramatic music, a lot of fun driving music like that. But then
then there's the pirates who don't do anything.
Scenes where the pirates who don't do anything are introduced. And so we've got to bring in their song, The Pirates Who Don't Do Anything. And they have a couple other little ditties that they sing that are just completely off the wall, kind of like the silly songs we've come to know and love. We've got a show-stopping gospel number in the middle. We've also got several other numbers that feel like a traditional Broadway musical from the 50s. And then, you know, the movie closes out with a Newsboys tune that's just really upbeat and a lot of fun. You'll be tapping your toes to it. So, again, we've got a big variety of music.
Wonderful. Well, Kurt Heinecke from Big Idea Productions, thanks so much for being on Radio Good News. Tell us again when Jonah opens up and how people can find out about it.
Absolutely. Jonah, Veggie Tales movie, opening October 4th at a theater near you. Check your local listings or head to bigidea.com.
Kurt Heinecke, thanks again for being on. God bless you.
Well, thank you very much for listening to Radio Good News today. I'm John Thornton. I want to encourage you, if you want to write to me, at P.O. Box 1722, Sioux Falls, South Dakota, 57101. And I also encourage you to check out a church family in this area where you can worship, be encouraged, and celebrate the love that God has for you. For this area offers many fine Bible-believing and teaching churches of various denominations. May you richly know the blessings of the God who was, the God who is, and the God who is to come again. And always remember, the Bible says love is patient, love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. Love does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. So love Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, with all your heart, strength, soul, and mind, and love your neighbors as yourselves. And as Christian people, we are commanded to love our enemies. Here at the end of the program today, we'll finish with a song from the new Jonah movie, which is opening October 4th. This is a song from Veggie Tales.
When I was a boy, I went to church back home in Arizona. And that is where I heard the tale of a man whose name was Jonah. Now, Jonah was a prophet, but that's not why he's remembered. We tell the tale, 'cause in a whale, he nearly was dismembered.
And you can spot it.
A doodly-doo!
He did not get the point.
Compassion and mercy from me to you and you to me. Exactly what God wants to see. And yes, that is the point.
Jonah was a prophet.
Ooh, ooh.
But he really never got it.
Sad but true.
And you'll be watching, you can spot it.
A doodly-doo!
He did not get the point.
Now Jonah set sail on a pirate ship in a dreadful gale.
Got eaten up by a giant whale, but managed not to be dead. You'd think he would learn a lot from being saved from an awful spot. But the second chance that he had got, he didn't want to be spread. So poor old Jonah, and now he's all alone. Gotta use a megaphone to get it through to his head.
Inside a large aquatic mammal, but all the same, like Jonah, there is something you can do. Everyone deserves to get a second chance.